So Boston got strep throat. She didn't get better. Took her like a week. And then I finally took her to the doctor. They told me that she had leukemia. We spent about 9 days the first time in a hospital. And she started chemo. She got bags of blood. She got bags of platelets. Then we got to go home for like a week. And then she got an infection with a fever. So we had to go back to the hospital for 5 days. So she got diagnosed on August 17th. And now we're in phase two, almost phase three of treatment. So we've been battling this for maybe about almost 3 months now. And she can't go to school, so we had to withdraw her from school, and she can't go back to school until next year. So just created a lot of obstacles that we weren't expecting. Yeah, the hair was probably the hardest part, because at first she was like really upset that her hair was falling out and like she didn't understand. But then like one day she came downstairs after a nap and she was like, "I'm tired of my hair falling out. Will you shave it off for me?" But now we're off steroids and we're just doing oral chemo, and that has returned her a lot more sleep.
So we just drove straight up to primaries, and within 10 minutes of being at primaries, like, they literally did a CT scan and said she has cancer. And that was the hardest thing to accept, because just earlier that year we had Maggie, and she was born with congenital heart defects. I ended up losing my job over it. It's just been financially draining, but we're still at the hospital. I mean, almost like 3 times a week probably. And every day, you know, like, is a doctor's appointment or a blood draw or, you know, something to remind us that we're battling this cancer, you know? Like, you know, at the beginning I was very cautious about what to tell her. But I learned that, like, I started saying, "Well, you have like a really nasty bug in your head that we have to get rid of." And then I realized, no, because as a kid thinking a bug in your head, I just had to blatantly just say, "You have cancer and this will take your life if we do not fight it." So she knows how severe this is, that she has to go through these things, no matter how hard they are. I mean, I just constantly remind her how, like, every single day I think I tell her, like, I know I tell her, you know, how beautiful she is and how strong she is, you know. And there's days like where she had such severe bone pain and neuropathy that she told me that she couldn't do this anymore. That was the hardest moment, I think, to date. Because I told her and I said, I don't ever want to see or hear you say that again, because we're not even halfway done. Like, you know, it's so heartbreaking that a 5-year-old has to say that. She, like, is very, you know, aware of her medical, like, situation, you know? Like, you know, she's mentioned how unfair it is, and I know it is, and I tell her that too. Like, I know it's completely unfair. She's strong. She's so strong, and she's so feisty. I know that she will fight with all of her might.
They told us that Benjamin had cancer, a big tumor on his stomach. A lot of chemos and treatments and that, they'd be able to take the tumor out, so he was starting feeling much better. He passed a lot of things, a lot of surgeries, 10 surgeries. He is almost done with the treatment. We are so happy to he passed everything now and he's getting better. He was taking all the time very positive, very, very positive, and, you know, he's been an example for the family, even because normally we, you know, seen our kids sick all the time, really, really bad, make us very sad, and feeling like he's... He won't be here with us anymore. So as a parent, as a mom, it's like heartbreaking all the time. But he's always positive. He's always like that, happy. Even when he's in pain, he's always trying to be smiling.
A couple days before Valentine's Day, her therapist, one of her physical therapists, said, you need to know she looks pretty pale to me. I would go get something checked.
Yeah, so Valentine's Day was pretty rough. We got her levels checked that day, and that's when we found out she had cancer. With Down syndrome, they are likely to get cancer, but they're also very likely to be able to beat it.
With Down syndrome, you're more likely to die from the toxicity of the chemo than you are the cancer. The cure rate is like in the 90%, 95%.
But she has struggled with.
She's had a couple of other.
We've had some really big scares where we didn't know if she was gonna make it. She's pulled through and she's a super fighter. In a lot of ways, it's actually brought our family closer together because, we're going through something hard, and
our family's completely different in a good way, in many good ways because of it. We do enjoy time together. We enjoy the little things. We like, it's less about what we have and more about the experiences we have.
Well, and people, people ask you, they're like, how do you do it? And you're like,
how do you not? you just kind of do it.
Do it because you want to keep her. She's an amazing example to us of how to be happy even when you're going through really hard things. And that even though you might not feel great yourself, that you can still share love with other people.
She's in dance and we were practicing the splits and pointing, and she couldn't point her toe down. Her calf was smaller than the other. We had her seen by orthopedic. They did some MRIs and they discovered that there was a tumor inside of her nerve in her leg. And he said, yeah, we can go in, we'll schedule surgery, and they can go into the nerve and they can open it up and they can remove all the tumor. After the initial surgery, he came out to tell us that he saw something that was abnormal. He said, we just close it up and then try to figure out how to treat it. December 12th, I remember specifically my husband and I had gone to Costa Vida and we were waiting in line. We got a call from our doctor and basically to tell us that it was cancer and that they would have to come up with a plan to treat it. And we're coming up on all these milestones of first, like a year since. We found out that it was a tumor one day before her birthday. Her birthday is on the 22nd. On our anniversary, we found out that it was cancer. So it was, these milestones are coming up and I'm just trying to just stay positive about everything that we've been through and the fact that she's here and she's okay and they've got it. She's cancer free. It's just like a huge blessing.